We in America should be very, very frightened about our Bill of Rights right now. We in America should be very, very frightened by this administration. Because it appears to me, ladies and gentlemen, that almost anything goes right now if the purpose is to re-elect Barack Obama or cover up his errors, his mistakes, his failures. So we have some guy in Southern California who put together a YouTube video mocking or criticizing Muhammad. In America, nobody cares. In America, this crap's done all the time. It's being used as an excuse to cover up his weakness on national security by this administration, and the president in particular, the fact that he hasn't sat in his chair in the Oval Office for an intelligence briefing for weeks. He didn't do it in the days before 9/11 or on 9/11, and we don't know if he's even done it since. You see, this rips at the false narrative that they've created around this president, that he has a special bond with Muslims, with the Middle East, that he's a different kind of president, that he can accomplish things that other presidents cannot accomplish. He's an incompetent ideological buffoon who has a tendency toward fascistic tactics. Sorry, somebody's got to say it. And it is a mindset that if it goes unchecked in a second term, this country will be different, and perhaps forever. When I saw that photograph on the Drudge Report of this nobody who had to clothe himself the way he did, oh, we're told by law enforcement that that was his decision. Well, of course, he doesn't want to be murdered. Who covered his body, covered his face, covered his hair. All you could see were his eyes. I said, the country, we're losing it. We're losing it. Well, there may be some kind of a probation or parole violation. So what? Our government's first concern should be the protection of a citizen. Instead, we know his address, we know his name, and as I speak, he and now his family are in hiding. They've left their home. And for what? And for whom? Hillary Clinton, time and time again last week and over the weekend, asserted that this film, this video, was the cause of what's been transpiring and has transpired in the Middle East. The President of the United States doing exactly the same. The UN Secretary from the U.S., our ambassador to the UN, saying exactly the same. The talking points are out. And we know what occurred in Libya at the consulate had nothing to do with this. Nothing. And yet this president uses it for his own political purposes. And because he cannot bear the thought of losing power. Yes, I saw that photograph and I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. I cannot believe the way the media are going along with this either. As much disdain as I have for them, you would think at some point they would say, wait a minute. There is a line somewhere, and yet the line wasn't there yesterday. So now this family is in hiding. In the United States, it's in hiding. The man and his family should have 24-hour protection, not because we agree with what he did. I haven't even looked at the YouTube thing, and 99% of the people talking about it haven't, and 99.9% of the people protesting haven't, and that murder in Libya, or murders, I should say, had nothing to do with it. And so our reaction, when Al-Qaeda, and I suspect the Libyan government, frankly, are involved in raping and murdering an American ambassador and three other souls, is to make a spectacle of our Constitution and our legal system.